All of you from the same state?
No.
Oh no, you know, we're all over.
Ohio. Ah, perfect stuff. So I'm basically born and raised within the Cape Town area, okay? So the tour takes about plus minus 30 to 40 minutes maximum.
Okay.
But I'll try and do it a bit quicker, seeing that it is cold and you can't really see much today. Okay.
You're scaring people. Man, you're fine.
Trust me. How warm does it get here?
It's quite warm. If you were in the Cape on about today, Saturday, Thursday. Thursday, we basically had a heat wave. So the temperature was probably about 30, 32 degrees Celsius.
Okay.
I know you guys work with Fahrenheit. So I'm not really sure how
it's
much.
It's a formula. I don't remember the form.
It's probably about 70, 80 degrees Fahrenheit.
Oh, yeah.
Like
so that would be perfect weather for you guys.
Yeah.
Nonetheless, guys, I'm going to start off, by explaining where we are now.
Yes.
So this is what we call the 12 Apostles Terrace. Okay, so it is the only allocated smoking area at the top of the mountain, and in case any fires breaks along the top of the mountain or in any of the buildings behind you guys, this is basically the meeting up point for that. Okay. Also, it is named after a few mountain ranges, which is normally under the clouds over here. Okay. So that mountain, it's called the 12 Apostles Mountain Range. Okay, but the name is quite deceiving, because there's not actually 12 mountain peaks, there's actually 18 mountain peaks, but there's quite a myth behind the name. It goes about back in the days when the British colony still occupied the Cape. A British ship basically entered the Atlantic seaboard, which is the ocean also below the clouds over here, which you guys seem too happy not to be able to can see at the moment. Nonetheless, it was a similar day like today. It was cloudy, it was very windy and stormy. So on entering the bay, the ship basically struck a rock, and it was on the verge of sinking. So while the ship was sinking, the crew on board basically decided that it's their last moments, so they would all start to pray. And while they started praying, the clouds which covered the 12 Apostles mountain range basically dropped just to the extent that 12 mountain peaks were sticking out instead of all 18. So they used these 12 mountain peaks as a landmark to make their way to shore. And upon arriving safely at shore, the entire crew arrived safely, and they basically believed that these 12 mountain peaks symbolized the 12 apostles of Jesus Christ. Hence, they believed these guys protected them on making their way to the shore. And ever since then, it has been known as the 12 Apostles Mountain Range.
Okay? There we go again.
Then normally you see this little animal over here. Okay? If you have a look over here, it's a looks like a rat. It's called a dasi, or a rock hyrax. And a dasi is basically a Dutch term for badger. And this little guy, they grow about this big, and it's actually the closest living relative of the African elephant. Believe it or not, as small as they are, scientists basically figured out that the bone structure of the dasi and the bone structure of that of the elephant, it's made up of similar compounds. So these guys normally run along the rocks over here, and the reason they don't fall off the rocks, they basically have a sticky substance which excretes out of their pores, allowing them to stick to the rocks and run up and down. They also have a collapsible rib cage, so in case any predators attack them, they could squeeze through that gap or beneath any of the rocks where they actually live as well. And one thing about the female dasi, back in the days before medicine, the indigenous people actually used the droppings of the female dasi when she was on a menstrual cycle. They used the droppings or the chemicals which excretes during a menstrual cycle. It crystallizes on the rocks, and the indigenous people scratched these crystals off, and they basically cooked it up and drank it as a herb or tea in order to detox the system. Okay, so that was what the indigenous people used, and it actually makes sense because the dasi normally eats all the fynbos which you see around, and a lot of the fynbos is also used for medicinal purposes. But I'll get into that as we go a bit further along the line. Okay, guys, is there any questions as before we move on?
Not a one.
No problem. Has any of you guys heard of Camps Bay?
Who?
No. Camps Bay?
Camps Bay, yeah. Camps Bay.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the richest area in
That's
Cape Town.
One of the richest areas in Cape Town, even in South Africa,
in South
I would
Africa,
say.
Yes.
It's also found along the seaboard over here. Maybe your tour guide will take you down there if you have time. You will find the best beaches over
there.
The not recommended to swim at though. It's nice for tanning in sunny days. But the water temperature basically drops quite low because it does form part of the Atlantic Ocean. And the reason why the water is so cold, it's basically much closer to the Antarctic icebergs. So once the Antarctic icebergs melt, it basically brings that current along the west coast of Cape Town, making this water extremely cold over here. Okay, guys? Lovely stuff. So we're going to take a walk up in this direction, much deeper into the clouds now.
Excellent, excellent introduction, appreciate you.
No stress, my man. How long did you say you guys are staying in Cape Town?
We're leaving tomorrow.
Leaving tomorrow?
We're here for 3 days.
So you had to do Table Mountain today.
Oh, without a doubt. It's perfect.